What's going on, everyone? Austin John Plays here, and today I'm going to be going over how you could complete the Fun Island Rupee Freefall Challenge in Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD. If you've been following along my 100% walkthrough, then you may have seen me cover this very briefly, and if you haven't been covering it, and this is just the first video you're finding on the subject, well then welcome, and feel free to check out the 100% walkthrough. Anyways, if you're not familiar, after you get the Isle of Songs, which is after Thunderhead clears up, you fight the Imprisoned for the first time, and right before you head to Farron in order to do the Spirit Challenge, you can actually make your way over here to Fun Island and have a little chat with Dodo over here. At first you're gonna find him and he's not gonna have his little disc on his back or anything, and you actually need to talk to him after you revive Scrapper, and that's a whole side quest. Again, check out my walkthrough for that. I mostly wanted to focus on the strategy on how to actually get the maximum amount of rupees, how to do it super easy, barely an inconvenience, and in addition to that, you need to get a perfect score in order to get the Piece of Heart. I want to go over some of the fundamentals here. The brown spots right here, if you land on them, you get 0 rupees. Green is obviously 1, red is 20, the blues are 5. The black ones are the rupors. They're rupees that make you lose 10 rupees, and they're the rarest. And then this one right here has 2 red and 2 blue, so it's 50 rupees. There are multipliers in the sky and also things that reset your multipliers, and ultimately what you strive to do is go through, hit all 5 rings, that makes your multiplier times 10, it's times 2 for each of the rings consecutive, now hit none of the balls, and then land on this spot. And the trick is, as you go through the very last ring, wherever this spot is, that's where it's going to be when you actually hit the ground. That only remains true after you go through all 5 of the rings, because every ring that you go through is actually going to slow down the speed of the actual spinning Madu Bababer. For this, I would definitely recommend turning on button-only controls, just so you have a little bit more control when you're going through the sky. It's 20 rupees every time you want to do this. If you didn't know about the whole it land landing there sort of thing, then this kind of isn't the best thing to get money, because it seems like it's up to luck, and really it's not. You see these little blue dots on the side? They're there to help you kind of gauge where you're going to be landing. And if we look over here at the 50 space, it only takes up 2 of these dots, the same size as the rupors next to it, as opposed to, say for example, this blue over here, which takes up double the size. So it's one small sliver, and it's 1/16th of the board, so it's pretty small place to land in. But honestly, as long as you focus on that one exact spot where you need to be landing, it's not that difficult. I'm now going to hide my face to do this. Being shot up in the air, I'm going to definitely recommend try to stay as close to the middle at all times. For the first, obviously you're going to have to make your way outside of the circle, outside of the center a little bit. Great. Back to the middle. That allows us to cut over to this one. This is a single ball, I'm not too worried about it. And if we head through this one, we now reset to the middle. You always want to head back to the middle. Great. Now we're about to hit the last one, and we want to focus on exactly where it was, which was right there. Just like that. 500 rupees. Dodo's gonna be super excited when you land on the 50 space. Multiplier of 10, that's 500 rupees. Big old bag of winnings. That's right, buddy. I took a screenshot video just so I could actually refer back to this before we're actually going into like post editing and stuff. But if I look right here, I can see where I was when I went through the very last circle. I'm focusing down at the most bottom area, and I'm also referencing pink diamond in the middle, all the yellow that stick out of the side, to kind of get a reference of where that's going to be. So you see how I just went through it, and now we have this one yellow diagonal from the sun pointing out at it. I know that I want to land kind of there, but a little bit to the right, because I just went through the circle at the last second. Now I'm focusing at the bottom area. Easy, right there. And now I'm not touching anything, letting him go down. I did not go fast enough. So here's going to be a side-by-side of my first time and my second time. You're going to notice that in the first clip, I did this hard lean, and that hard lean was to actually get me in position. But when you do a hard lean, it actually speeds you up. And I took that into consideration to land exactly straight. However, in my second clip, I did a much loftier sideways sort of pan to the side, and because of that, I actually needed to compensate for that time, and I didn't, so because of that, I was delayed and I didn't land perfectly. So, after you go through that ring at the end, you should do sort of a hard cut to exactly where you need to land, and that should put you right above your target. Let's do this again. But just want to do a nice flawless 10. Okay, we want to stay as close to the middle as possible, and the pink blue is right here. At the end, I tilted a little bit to the right just because I felt like I wasn't falling fast enough. And honestly, if you happen to get lucky and it's near what I'm going to call the bottom area, like the bottom half that's visible, it's just a little bit easier that way, just because you can see it actually coming at you. Oh, Fee, what's wrong? Oh, my wallet is full. You're right, it sure is. Well, guys, I hope you found this video helpful on the second most difficult minigame in all of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. If you did, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button down below. Consider checking out some of my other Skyward Sword HD videos and my 100% walkthrough. If you're new to the channel, feel free to subscribe, turn on notifications. Until next time, Austin Chan out.